Hi everyone, this is Marissa with NOAA's Office of Education, back with part two of our layered hot chocolate activity. This is part of our Oceanography in a Mug series, and there are my cats again making a cameo in the video. And I have here a fancy cup of hot chocolate with a layer of espresso that I made using espresso powder I had in the cupboard and some warm milk. Now I'm going to show what happens when we do what we all do before we go to take a sip of a warm drink, which is to pick it up and blow gently across the surface to make sure it's not too hot. Let's watch what happens. Okay, first we can see that blowing across the surface of the cocoa forms small ripples. Believe it or not, this is the same way that wind-driven waves are generated in the ocean. Major ocean swells that travel across entire ocean basins and crash on the shore all get their start as tiny ripples like these ones. And this also shows that we generate a small surface current, which is different from the waves. This is actually moving the top layer of water away. And in the process, water from below is drawn up to replace it. This is bringing denser, cooler water to the surface. Or maybe in this case, this is bringing denser, heavier, more espresso-y water to the surface. Oceanographers call this phenomenon upwelling. And it brings dense, cold ocean water to the surface. Deep ocean water is also rich in nutrients because decaying marine life tends to settle, bringing nutrients to that part of the ocean. And without sunlight, algae can't grow and photosynthesize, so they can't use up the nutrients in the water. As a result, when upwelling takes place along the coast or in the open ocean, it's an important process in fertilizing the surface water, bringing those nutrients up to the surface to help algae grow and nourishing the base of the marine food web.